33-47. And if it ever come to the place which is called Calvary, there they crucified, and the malefactors, one on the right, one on the left. Then said Jesus, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. They parted his raiment and cast lots. And the people stood beholding. And the rulers also with them derided them, saying, He saved others, let him save himself, if he be Christ, the chosen of God. And the soldiers mocked him, coming to him and offered him vinegar, and saying, If thou be the king of the Jews, save thyself. The superscription also was written over him in letters of Greek, Latin, and Hebrew. This is the king of the Jews. And one of the malefactors which were hanged railing to him said, If thou be Christ, save thyself and us. But the other answered him, rebuked him, and saying, Dost not fear God, seeing thou art in the same condemnation? And we indeed justly, for we see the due reward of our deeds, but this man had done nothing. And he said unto Jesus, Lord, remember me when thou comest to thy kingdom. And Jesus says, Today thou shalt be with me in paradise. Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for this day, this night. Thank you for these wonderful people, our visitors. Most of all, Lord, we thank you for you for showing up tonight. Ask you, Lord, to hide me behind the cross. I won't utter a word unless it comes from you. For a decision that needs to be made tonight, this is it. Lord, be with Brother Kenneth in this condition with this test. Lord, we know that you can help him out on that problem. Lord, I thank you so much for everyone here tonight, all the they do for this church and all they do for Barbara and I, and we love them so much. Take control, Lord, and we'll give you the praise. In the precious name of Jesus, amen.
Amen.
You know, there were many places in the Bible that played a part in the life of our Lord. Bethlehem, Bethany, Nazareth, Jerusalem, Jordan, the hillside, Sea of Galilee, the synagogues and the villages. All of their places, all the places were merely just a path to his final destiny. He knew where he was going. Every step Jesus took in life was leading him to the place the Greeks called Tapas Cranium, the Hebrews called Golgotha, the Romans called Calvary. As we know today, it's a place of the skull. All the gospel Jesus said this was his destiny. The very morning of his death, he told Pontius Pilate that Calvary was the place he was going. John 18:37 says, To this end was I born, and for this cause came I into the world. I'd like for us to travel back a little while tonight to a place called Calvary and look at three facts which make it a special place. It's different from all others. Verse 33 said it was a place of unbeliever, torture. The phrase where they crucified him takes over 18 hours of suffering. And to full word, here's what our Lord served those 18 hours. You can imagine that our Lord hung on the cross. This is nothing like he hung on. He hung up like this, 18 hours of life. Nails in his feet, nails in his arms. He complained not, did he? Complained not. He had been arrested, tried, and convicted in a mock trial. Falsely witnessed to against him. He had been abused by the temple guards. Mark 14:65 says they spit on him. Covered their face. The servants struck him with the palms of their hand. He had been taken to Pilate, where he was abused by Pilate's own soldiers. He was scourged. Mark 15:16 said he released Barabbas to contend the people. Like a lot of churches today, we don't want to cause a big rift. Amen. But what we do is we go along with the consensus of the church. Well, it may hurt their feeling, may hurt everyone's feelings. My friend, I think when churches come to a point, and they're like that now, of scared you may offend them, you got to vote what the Lord says. And if some don't like it, they just need to go back to the Bible and see what the Lord says. Amen. He was beaten, Matthew 27:27 said he was spit upon again. Matthew 26:67, his beard was pulled out. I just think, Isaiah 56, he was crowned with thorns and was mocked. Our Savior had all this happen to him for not doing nothing wrong. Not doing nothing wrong. He was sentenced. He was sentenced to die and suffer along the Via Dolorosa. Look at the way of the suffering he carried his cross. 650 yards up the hill. That's two football fields. Carried it uphill. The crossbar weighed 110 pounds. That was on his arm. He suffered at Calvary. He was nailed to the cross. Mark 15:25 says the nails were long and large in diameter. Probably very rusty. The nails through the median nerve would cause massive spasms to his body. He would have to pull himself up, even to breathe. He submitted himself to the cross. I love that song. He could call 10,000 angels.
Amen.
But he chose not to. To get him off that cross. That wasn't the plan, was it? His plan was to die for us.
Amen.
Why? To demonstrate God's love. Romans 5:8 was to destroy sin. Hebrews 9:26 to defeat Satan. 1 John 3:8, he did it all for you and I. Why would the Lord so loving give his life? I'm talking about an awful life. We can't imagine what our Savior went through, not only on the cross, but the beating that he took the day before. Easter will be here in about 3 months. Jack Daniels used to call them your bunny Christians. They hop in, hop out. That's about the way they do it. I'm so thankful that we've got a group of people here tonight that love the Lord and are faithful. Amen. It blesses God's heart to see this church do this. And it blesses my heart, believe me. Amen. And every count of the death of Jesus on the cross, one little pronoun kept saying, they, but really you and I. Verse 18, they chose Barabbas over Jesus. Verse 21, he cried out for his death. Verse 23, they were determined to see him dead. Verse 25 and 26, they led him to a way to his death. And verse 35, they even mocked him as he died. What did he do? Deserve his treatment. All he'd ever done was good. He had healed the sick, raised the dead, fed the hungry, told them the truth, and yet they rejected him and demanded to be put to death. They chose Barabbas. What makes this so tragic is that Jesus was their Messiah. They waited for him, longed for him, looked for him. 4,000 years. And when he came, they refused to bow to him, just like so-called Christians today. We've turned our back on the Lord Jesus Christ, church. We've turned our back on him. We refuse to surrender our all. We surrender part of ourselves, but not our all. He's our only hope. People will do you wrong, but Jesus will not.
Amen.
John 14:6 said, I'm the way, the truth, and the life. No one cometh to the Father but for me. Friend, he loves you more than you'll ever know. More than you'll ever know.
Amen.
Verses 39 through 47 is a place of unequal trial. Yet not all was tragic that day. Jesus suffered a more horrible death than we can ever imagine. But he accomplished something of eternal importance. It was a place of triumph for one of the thieves. Amen. But it's also a place for whosoever will. It can be a triumph for you tonight if you don't know him. When Jesus died on that cross, he became sin for the whole world. He was judged by God, but when Jesus died on that cross, he paid a debt for the sins of everyone who would place their faith in him. He paid a debt he did not owe. He owed a debt he could not pay. His triumph was so complete that he was able to declare salvation's plan. It was finished with Jesus' last breath. It is finished, may have been just a whisper, but in heaven, God heard it. The angels heard it. And you can bet that Satan heard it.
Amen.
If you think we serve a dead God, you don't serve the God I serve.
Amen.
And we need to go back and see where you thought you found him. But he's alive. He's alive. We start this new year. What are you going to do with Jesus this year? Just ask yourself, what are you going to do? I'm going to do my best. And I know I'll fall up short, but to serve him with every breath that I've got. And we as a church should do the same thing. Amen. This morning, during invitation, nothing but what I've done, but the Spirit was moving so strong up here during invitation. I think we all had the main thing on our mind was to worship the Lord.
Amen.
But he loves us. He loves us. He had revival coming up in about a month and a half. Brother Jim Moss. Hope you started praying for it already. I believe that Jesus would have died if it had been that one person, Brother Gordon. I believe he would have died for that one, very one. He didn't die for the Baptist, the Methodist, the Assembly of God. He died for mankind.
Amen.
We're not going to have no departments in heaven. There's a black guy at Stuttgart asked his Baptist church preacher. He was just teasing him. He said, could he come over to his house and see him? Because the preacher had already made a statement that blacks are going to have their place and whites have their place. I said, well, he may not even be in heaven. I said, trying to tell where he's going to be having it.
That's not true at all.
So thankful that this church will welcome whosoever will.
Amen.
There's so many churches that don't. Y'all ought to be proud of this little church.
Yeah.
Miss Mary and Brother Gordon have been here a long, long time. And Miss Lori, seen a lot of changes. I think West Side is just like the Henson saying, the old ship of Zion. The Titanic sunk. Amen. Mm-hmm. But the old ship of Zion is not going to sink.
Amen.
The old ship running the rudder head and all is the Lord Jesus Christ. He knows what he's doing. He doesn't have to be told what he's doing. He knows what he's doing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I challenge you all to walk with the Lord as close as you can this new year. Tell people about Jesus. Tell people about Jesus. The Gaithers sing that there's something about that name.
Man.
Jesus. There he is hanging on the cross. His name is Jesus. Oh, what a lovely name. The name of Jesus.
Amen.
We're coming to a hymn of invitation. I want you to just stop and think. What are you going to try to do this year to worship God more? You may say, well,